not the sellout employers and members. We fought for these rights. We did not get them on the silver platter. Our blood spilled. Thousands of workers were dismissed. Thousands of our members were sentenced to poverty. They were tear gassed. They were tortured. They were maimed through the bullets of the apartheid regime. We will not allow anybody to touch our righteous life. If they don't want to listen to us today, comrades, let's tell you this. We are coming back for 2 days. But there's a difference. There is going to be the difference. We are going to take the buses and come here. We are going to take the planes and come here. We are going to take the taxis and come here. We will not leave the town until they announce that our rights are guaranteed. The normal will no longer help us cope. We need a radical response because they are taking our rights radically. We're going to have to respond radically. 2 days, we will sit in Johannesburg. We will sit in Pretoria. We will sit in Durban. We will sit in Cape Town. We will sit in Port Elizabeth. Until they fall. Until they fall. The sellouts of the revolution. So, to dwell, comrades, all of us, they can hear us. We are now going to demonstrate the power of the workers. We are going to occupy the Rissik Street from bottom to top. We will sit there for some time until Lendo is taken apart at Ipumule. Umtu othi masamkele i-R20 per hour. Umtu othi aba bantu baprodusa ukutya kweli lizwe, i-farm workers, masamkele i-R18 per hour. Umntu othi abamama bakhulisa abantwana babo mabamkele i-R15 ngehour. Umntu othi abasebenzi abakwi-extended public works program aba babenzisa umsebenzi wethu mabamkele i-R11 sibathini. Comrades, comrades, listen here. There has to be a new revolution in our country. There has to be a new revolution. The 24 years of democracy have meant nothing. They have meant hell for us. Did you hear the leaders of business? They issued a statement 2 days ago. You hear what they say? They are saying they believe they now are in heaven. They say on the 20th of December, the day Ramaphosa was elected president of the ANC, on that day it meant the heavens have been opened for them. Indeed, comrades, this is heaven. Alan Clegg, the CEO of SIP Milne, raked 152 million rands in 1 year in 2014 and in 2015. The CEOs of the Johannesburg listed companies on average are raking 17.97 million rand every year. A time they earn 69,000 rand. In an hour they rake 8,600 rand. Ramaphosa is earning 3.6 million. We know that is peanuts for him. We know that it is peanuts for him. He has much more money than the government can pay him. You remember, he tried to buy a buffalo for 18 million rands. He sold 3 impala bulls for 27 million rands. The same man, accompanied by those stooges in Kosatu, turn around and tell workers that 20 rand is enough for them. 18 rand is enough for them. They say the 12,500 rand. The Marikana Matthias died for cannot be afforded by this economy. But the same economy can afford to pay them 152 million rands in 1 year. You see, hypocrisy at its best. Our message to Ramaphosa and the ANC: we fought here. We were tortured here. We are not the Mafikizolos here. We suffered here. We were in prison here. We didn't do all of the sacrifices so that you alone can buy a buffalo for 80 million rands and then tell us that we can only live on the 20 rands a day. We're going to pass here as we go to the 6th Street. We will tell them that the 20 rand they want to give to workers, there is a nice space, a nice spot they can find at the back of their buffaloes. They must put the 20 rand there. We want 4,500 rands. So comrades, turn the trap fold orderly. We are working together. Asinamanga, asitunwanga manzi, siyazabalaza, sifunza imali yetu. Sifuna it decent work. Sifuna it better life for all. Sifuna it vertical economic transformation. High for all, for all of us. So comrade Mark, please, let's move.
Okay, before we go, can we clear our path, please? The officials from the Department of Health have assured us.
Okay, comrades, open up. Zolilwela.